All right, so we've got some Oxalum, I think is the way that's pronounced, LED bulbs for the Jeep Wrangler. Now these were sent to me for free, so just be aware of that. This is the 9008 or H13 bulb, and we're going to be putting these in the Jeep Wrangler and trying them out. Now, the first thing that I thought was impressive was that they actually send you a little pair of gloves so that you don't have to touch the bulb. That's more important on the halogen bulbs, or even HID bulbs. LED bulbs aren't, it's not that important, but it's a good practice not to touch the actual LED itself, which you can see it's easy enough to handle without actually touching the LED. Does come with a little manual. Not much to see here. The body is aluminum. The temperature range is minus 40 to 176 degrees. Going to install just like any other bulb, and I'm going to go show you that here in just a minute on this Jeep Wrangler. And then tonight, whenever it gets dark, we're going to take it down the road and see how it performs. So let's take a look at the body of this. Now, this is a fanless design. Now, the Wrangler's got LED bulbs in it right now, and there's actually a fan on the back of those bulbs. And the one thing I've always been worried about is that fan will quit eventually, and the LED could possibly overheat. Now, this entire body, all the way up to this part right here, is aluminum, as you can see. And this is a high and a low beam bulb. But the entire body is, it looks like cast aluminum, so it's going to act as a heat sink. And I mean, the quality looks fine to me. So the question is, how's this going to fit the headlight housing, and how's it going to perform tonight? So let's go ahead and go over to the Jeep, and I'll show you how easy it is to put bulbs in it. So the first thing you've got to do is get these little push pins out. And you can get in here with a little screwdriver with these tight pliers that I've got here. Once you get all the push pins out, it's just a matter of pulling out and then snapping it out from the bottom. The bottom has just got little tabs that hold it in. And then you've got the bulbs for the turn signals. And I just unscrew them from the housing. And what I mean by that is I just do the whole bulb. I leave the bulb in it. Just let it hang just like that. And now you just need, I think it's a, I'm not sure what size Torx. I'll let you know as soon as I grab it. All right, so it's a T15. I'm just going to zip these out of here. I'm going to get the bottom ones first. That way it'll hang with the top ones. So this LED bulb, I've seen better days, it looks like. The bulbs that's in here is probably about 5 years old. And I remember I had to zip tie this connector because it just wouldn't quite latch all the way. Got a little tab right there. You got a little red tab. You got to push that up, and then you can push the latch release down. Here's the one that was in it. That's the little fan I was talking about. Just for comparison. That's the way that they've been able to not have to have a fan on this one is because of that huge housing that's all made out of aluminum. This one, you can see that there's very little aluminum to it. The heat sink is aluminum, but it's got its own individual fan. The problem is if this fan ever quits, now it may not get enough airflow across it to remove the heat. I want to go ahead and install this in the headlight first. Now these do go in one way, so make sure you get them in right. There's a little notch that you want to make sure it's all lined up, and the bulb should fit in there just fine. And this one's done. The other side's the same exact way, so I'm not going to film it. Let me get this bulb in that other side, and then tonight, whenever it gets dark, we'll take it up and down the road, and we'll see how they work. And just to give you a little view of what these are like, that's all that's holding the bottom in. They just snap in right here. So you just pull out on the bottom with your hand after you get the top push pins pulled out, and the whole thing will pop out. And then just don't forget to disconnect your lights. Anyway, we're done. I just ops checked the lights. They do work. So tonight, we'll take it for a spin. I'm going to put the grill back on and be done. Hey guys, this is nighttime driving. With the LED headlights. And it brightens up the entire roadway. There's high beams. It's like having brand new headlights installed. There's low beam. It's nice and bright and white. We will catch you in the next one. You guys take care.